today's money, it would be $2 to $6 for a 14-hour workday of shoveling rocks. Does that sound like a good deal? Store in town. If you guys were lucky and had a doctor's office, you could spend it at the doctor. You would even spend your rent money. So all of your money would be going back to the company, basically. Because they were not making a lot of money, the coal miners would send their families home to work, which means the kids would go to work too. If you were 8 years old or older, you would be up on the surface, breaking apart rock from coal using a pickaxe. If you were 12 or older, you would be down here on this level of the mine with the grown-ups, opening up doors for these carts to pass through, or little kids have little hands. Those are tools. You'd be using those working on some big machine. That's pretty dangerous work. In the 1920s and 30s, the coal miners all got together and talked about how frustrated they were with their working conditions, things they wanted to see change, and they formed the first unions in our country and set up our 8-hour workday that we've got today, the first minimum wage, and they ended child labor. So those are all a great improvement on the coal mining industry, but this is still a very dangerous job. We still have a lot of hazards. So we're gonna head upstairs and I'll show you guys some 1920s safety equipment. On the way, we're gonna pass by this stuff from World War 17. Down here, yeah, we're right.
Green.
Blue. Yeah, maybe a little bit of green. Yeah. But that's our sign that it's time later, excuse the minor interruption, we are innovating. We make this little device. This is called a pocket methanometer. The way that it works is there's a filter on the backside that lets air flow in, just like that lantern. But instead of the color change, we get a digital readout on the front side. Plus, if the alarm goes off, there is a hammer on the inside that will start banging around. And you would be wearing this maybe here on your belt, so you can feel when it's time to get out of the mine. Instead of needing to look for a color change or listen for a little songbird to stop singing. So this is going to give you an immediate sign to get out. Now these are installed at every piece of mining equipment that goes down. We got some regulations in place now. I'm going to have you guys guess.
What are those up there?
What are those? That's a great question. Those are canaries. Have you ever heard the phrase canary in a coal mine?
No.
Some of us? Yeah, that's a phrase that people still use. No, those are just toy canaries. But before they had these lanterns, they would be bringing birds down into the mines. Those little birds love to sing, and so they would be singing all the time. And when gases come in that are difficult for them to breathe, they would stop singing, and that's when the coal miners would know to get out. But that's not so nice to the birds, so that's why they stopped doing it. They don't do that anymore. But these are still used around the world today. They were banned in the United States in 2001. So people were using them up through the 21st century. I know, you probably wouldn't want to bring these down because it's just not safe enough. So that is why they
put them on. But then you poke yourself.
Yeah, you could poke yourself. Yeah, why not?
Poke yourself.
Oh, yeah.
Oh my God. We definitely don't want to do that. Yeah. We are going to go a bit further into the mine. We're going to head on to the 1930s and see the equipment that brings the coal out of the wall. Do you have a question?
Is that the car you guys going?
Yes!
Yay!
We are going to have a train ride. I can't
believe we do a train ride.
It is pretty fun. The beginning, it's going to be a little dark and loud, and then we're going to make a pit stop. We're going to see some mannequins. Hard at work. Fair warning. But you guys can head on in, make yourself comfortable.
Yes.
Grace, stop.
Designed and built by FMC Corporation, drills holes into the ceiling. A bolt is anchored into the stronger sandstone above the coal seam to hold the roof in place. This drilling pattern provides a safer area in which miners can work. Without this safeguard, the roof might sag and eventually collapse. FMC roof bolting provides a safer and more permanently secure environment than former methods of roof support.
please watch your fingers there for me? Thank you.
Not my ear.
And there's a little bit of a hop down. Okay, would you?
Excuse
me. We're gonna get there via Miss Polly. We're gonna go out to Drill Cave Polly on the million years ago, Illinois was a giant marsh full of bogginess and plants. And when those plants died, they became the coal seam that we've got today. You guys can follow me through here. Keep your eye on the top.
Now, also kind of neat, when it moves forward,
and that collapses behind it, this machine is gonna bury itself underground. It's a huge operation, $70 million, and it gets abandoned below ground. They don't come and take it back up to the surface, because that's even more work and money, so they just kind of leave it and go make another one somewhere else. So we do have a couple that are buried under Illinois right now. I kind of like to think as a silver lining to things, maybe we will find them again in a million years. It'll be like the fossils of our time.
The fossils of our time.
Yeah, it kind of stinks. It kind of stinks. But
I can mention in the future, are y'all going to like, what the fuck is this?
What is this?
Yeah.
Yeah, I would be kind of confused.
Is strip mining a totally
different thing?
It
looks like a gold
computer. Yeah, that's just, it's going at different depth. So this machine would be used between, roughly between like 600 and like 1500 feet below the surface. The old Ben 17 mine went down about 300, 400 feet. But yeah, there are different like styles of mining, like quarry style mining, there's mountainside mining, things like that. It's mostly just how low you need to go. Yeah. We got one more step on our tour. We're talking about the future of energy production. If you've heard of a way we can make electricity without coal, I might ask you about it. Coal,
Thank you. in the background.
Thank you.
Yeah.